Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Jeff Ping. We're going to spend some time today talking about osteoarthritis. Now I see so many people get diagnosed with osteoarthritis, but they don't really have a good understanding of what that means. They kind of assume, well, it's just part of getting older and I need to learn how to deal with it. So my goal here is to try to educate more people that there are ways to manage osteoarthritis, that there are ways to treat the symptoms, and that there are even injections that we can potentially give to prevent it from getting worse. Now before we dive deeper, a quick disclaimer, my content is truly only meant for educational purposes only. If you have medical concerns, please seek the advice of your physician. What is said during this video reflects my opinion at this point in time, and this can change as our understanding of osteoarthritis continues to advance. So what is osteoarthritis? Osteoarthritis is a wear and tear condition. It affects the knees, the hips, the ankles, the shoulders, the spine, the hands, pretty much every joint, and it occurs due to the loss of articular cartilage. So all of our long bones are padded by a thick layer of articular cartilage, and this cartilage acts as a cushion. It protects our bones when we walk, when we run, when we jump, when we go up and down stairs, when we play sports. It really helps to create a frictionless environment so that our joints can move smoothly. And osteoarthritis is the loss of this articular cartilage. So what happens is when we lose this protective layer, the underlying bone gets exposed. And rather than having a smooth surface to glide against, you're kind of grinding against a sandpaper-like material. And so all that grinding and crunching, all of that leads to symptoms. Symptoms like stiffness, inflammation, swelling, and pain. Now it's really important to understand that osteoarthritis is a chronic progressive disease, and we really need to start thinking about it just like any other chronic progressive disease. For example, a person with high blood pressure that's not treated has an incredibly high risk for heart attack or a stroke, but we don't wait for someone to have a heart attack before we treat their underlying high blood pressure. We know if it's not treated, it's going to lead to poor outcomes. So we really need to start thinking about osteoarthritis in this same way, that it is a chronic progressive disease. If we don't treat it, it tends to get worse. And when it gets worse, it causes more pain and it causes more disability. The other important thing we need to understand about osteoarthritis is that the more osteoarthritis you have, the more osteoarthritis you are at risk for getting in the future. And so why is that? Well, it's because every time your articular cartilage gets damaged, those dying cartilage cells release a bunch of toxic enzymes and toxic proteins into your joint. These toxic enzymes and toxic proteins lead to inflammation, and inflammation weakens and damages whatever cartilage cells are remaining. And when those remaining cartilage cells get damaged, they then release a bunch of toxic enzymes and proteins, and this further damages whatever cartilage is left. And so soon you start having more and more of your cartilage cells dying off, and when they die off, they release a bunch of toxic enzymes and proteins that further damages whatever else is remaining. And you can see how this feedback loop can get you from mild osteoarthritis to end-stage bone-on-bone osteoarthritis fairly quickly. So then the question becomes, how do we break this feedback loop? The question we are asking is, how do we slow down the progression of osteoarthritis? Currently, there are really just three ways to do this, and we're going to go through each one of these. The first is physical activity. The more you move, the more you exercise, the less pain you will have. Now, when I tell this to people, I often get a blank look in return. They're thinking something along the lines of, I have pain in my knees, and you want me to move more? And I emphatically tell them, absolutely yes. What we know is physical activity and exercise in the long run will help you feel better. And the reason for this is when you move, when you are physically active, your body and your joints will naturally produce lubrication. So if you do have an underlying bone that is exposed, that grinding and crunching of that sandpaper-like material can actually be covered with a layer of lubrication. And this will decrease stiffness and this can decrease pain. So I tell people with osteoarthritis, the day you stop moving is the day your symptoms get way worse. When you stop moving, you stop producing lubrication. That grinding and crunching starts again. The stiffness, the inflammation, the swelling, all that pain will return. So the first is critical. Physical activity and exercise will help treat and manage osteoarthritis. Now the second is weight management. Do everything in your ability to prevent weight gain. Try to stay weight neutral, or if you are overweight, try to lose weight. And this comes down to a very simple physics problem. The more weight you carry around in your abdomen, the more weight you put through your hips, your knees, your ankles, your joints, your spine. This causes more wear and tear, and more wear and tear leads to more osteoarthritis. Now, if we want to get a little bit more technical about this, there are a few other factors in play here. Fat tissues actually release signaling molecules called adipokines. And these adipokines actually circulate in the body and they cause inflammation in the joints. And this is why obesity is actually one of the greatest risk factors for osteoarthritis. And it even explains why obese patients have very high rates of osteoarthritis in non-weight-bearing joints like the hands. So the goal here is to lose weight, or at least to stay weight neutral. Now, some people have a problem here. Some people are in so much pain that they can't exercise, that they can't be physically active, and because of this, they end up putting on more weight. And so that's where pain medications come in. Oral anti-inflammatory medications like aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen, meloxicam, all of these can help reduce inflammation and reduce swelling. Pain medications like acetaminophen or Tylenol can also help, but it's really important to understand that none of these medications help treat the underlying disease. They don't treat osteoarthritis, but if they can help reduce pain, if they can help reduce swelling, if they can help reduce symptoms, then they serve a purpose. The goal of these medications is to reduce symptoms so that you are able to be more physically active, so that you are able to exercise, because in the long run, that's what's going to help you the most. Now, some people have it really bad. For some people, oral medications don't do anything. And that's where injections come in. And injections are potentially the third way of delaying the progression of osteoarthritis. Historically, we gave cortisone injections to help treat those with osteoarthritis. Now, cortisone is a steroid. It is a very strong anti-inflammatory medication. It is a very strong pain medication. It will help reduce your pain, and it will help reduce your swelling. And if it can reduce your symptoms so that you can start moving again, so that you can start exercising, so that you can be more physically active, then it plays a role. However, we are learning that there are quite a few issues with cortisone injections. The first is that we can't actually predict how long the effects are going to last, right? For some people, it's 6 months. For some people, it's 9 months and even a year. For some people, it's 3 weeks. So we can't predict how long the effects are going to last. But again, if it can help reduce your symptoms, even temporarily, so that you can start moving again, then it plays a role. The other big problem with cortisone injections is that we are slowly learning that multiple cortisone injections are actually toxic to the joint. Cortisone can potentially degrade articular cartilage. This means that over time, multiple cortisone injections can actually worsen and cause more osteoarthritis in the long run. So we are really moving towards two other types of injections for the treatment of knee osteoarthritis. And these two other options are called hyaluronic acid injections and platelet-rich plasma injections. Studies involving patients with knee osteoarthritis suggest that both of these injections can slow the progression of osteoarthritis and delay the need for a knee replacement. So let's talk about these. What is hyaluronic acid? Well, this is a naturally produced substance found in joints. Hyaluronic acid serves as a lubricant. You can try to imagine this like WD-40 for your joints. What we can do is we can synthetically make it, put it in a syringe, and inject it into a joint with osteoarthritis. Hyaluronic acid has anti-inflammatory properties and can actually reduce pain, reduce stiffness, and reduce inflammation. What about platelet-rich plasma injections? Well, platelet-rich plasma injections are one of the newest type of injections that we're doing in orthopedics. These injections use your own body's platelets to help treat the underlying osteoarthritis. So how does this work? Well, we first draw your blood. We spin it down in a centrifuge. Your blood separates out into layers. We take the layer that has all your platelets and inject it back into an area that's been irritated or injured. And you think about, well, why would this work? Let's say I fall and I have a big laceration over my forearm. It's red, it's hot, it's swollen, it's angry, it's painful. But if we give it time, a scab forms over that laceration. The scab falls off, and then you get this pink-white looking granulation tissue. That tissue continues to remodel, and if you give it a few months, you get brand new skin. So this entire healing process is initiated and controlled by platelets. So our platelets are responsible for tissue healing, tissue remodeling, tissue proliferation, and most importantly, controlling inflammation and pain. And all we're doing is using your own body's capacity to control pain and to control inflammation. concentrating it, and then injecting it back into an area that's been irritated. And when you look at the studies comparing platelet-rich plasma injections to cortisone injections, and platelet-rich plasma injections to hyaluronic acid injections, it's clear. The people who get platelet-rich plasma injections do far better. And this is true for time points at 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and even 1 year out. Remember, a joint with osteoarthritis has all these toxic enzymes and proteins circulating around in the joint. This creates an environment that is extremely toxic. Platelet-rich plasma injections introduce a huge amount of growth factors and anti-inflammatory signaling molecules that can really help change the environment of the joint. And once we successfully change the environment of the joint, the stiffness improves, the swelling improves, and the pain improves. The most important thing to take away from this video is that osteoarthritis is a chronic progressive disease. If it is not treated, it will get worse. And that is why it is so important to stay physically active, to exercise daily, and to manage your weight. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this information useful, please share with others who may also benefit. Please also share your thoughts in the comments below, and let me know if you have any ideas for future content. Please also consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. I can be found on Twitter at JeffreyPengMD, and I write on my blog at JeffreyPengMD.com.